when you tell these people that Allah is the one who created the heavens and the earth. Allah is the one who created the sun, the stars, the galaxies. Allah is the one who created the night and the day. Allah is the one who created the ocean. And in the ocean, there's a layer of salty water and sweet water, and it does not mix. Allah is the one who created the fire of hell. They surrounded by four walls. One wall is so thick, they will take a person 40 years to cover his distance, surrounded by 70,000 whips. On each whip, there's 70,000 angels, meaning 4,900,000,000 angels dragging the fire of hell. Allah is the one who created angels, that the distance between the earlobe and the neck is 70,000 years. Allah is the one who gave the miracle to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he parts the moon. He takes one side of the moon on one side of the mountain, the other side of the moon on the other side of the mountain. Allah is the one who gave the miracle to Musa alayhi salam, that he parts the ocean, mountains of water are raised, and they make the crossing. Allah is the one who gave the miracle to Suleiman alayhi salam, that he became the ruler of the two worlds. That when he used to travel, a tornado used to come, lift his army up and take them to a different destination. Allah is the one who gave the miracle to Ibrahim alayhi salam, that he slaughters a bird, he puts his head by his feet, and he puts the flesh on different parts of a mountain, and how he calls in the name of Allah, and his flesh gathers, forms into a bird, and he flies off in front of the eyes of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah is the one that will roll up all the heavens in his hands, he will roll up all the worlds in his hands, and he will say that I am the king of all kings. Man's are not hype. Where is the hype gone for the king of the worlds, master of the universe, Allah the Almighty? Where is the hype gone when you know that Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty is the one who created the seven heavens, and the distance between the first and the second is 500 years. The second and the third is 500 years. The third and the fourth is 500 years. The fourth and the fifth is 500 years. The fifth and the sixth is 500 years. The sixth and the seventh is 500 years. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is above all. Where is the hype gone now for the king of the worlds, master of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty? Tupac is praised. Biggie is praised. Floyd Mayweather is praised. Skepta is praised. Kim Kardashian is praised. Stormzy is praised. Nicki Minaj is praised. But where is the praise gone for the king of the world? When you travel the world and you see how many people are in this world, you will realize that it's a mind-boggling number. And then you understand this: from the time of Adam al-Islam, Nuh, Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Saleh, Lut, Yaqub, Musa, Yusha, Ilyas, Yunus, Ayub, Dawood, Yahya, Isa, Muhammad alayhi salam, right till this present day, how many nations have come, how many nations have gone, how many nations have come in this world, and how many have perished? Allahu Akbar, mind-boggling number. And then you realize something, that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you something so unique, that He did not just give anyone else, He gave you, and this was your own identity. He did not just give you a passport, He did not just give you an ID card, He did not just give you a student visa, He gave you something so unique. Allahu Akbar. And that was the fingerprint. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You will not find a person on the face of this earth with the same fingerprint as you. You will die with this fingerprint, you'll be resurrected with this fingerprint, and inshallah you'll be in Jannah with the same fingerprint. Who is the one who gave this identity? It was the King of all kings, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty. Thomas Edison, why is he praised? Because he invented the electric light bulb. Why is Tim Berners-Lee praised? Why? Because he invented the HTTP protocol for the internet. Steve Jobs, why is he praised? Benjamin Franklin, why is he praised? When the king of the world, master of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla, is the best of creators, is the best of makers, is the best of shapers. My brothers, you don't need to go far. You look in that mirror and you realize that the one who created you is the king of the worlds, master of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla, the mighty. Then you just look at the human eye. The Lord, the Almighty, gave you. He gave every single person. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So powerful is this eye that it consists of 576 megapixels. It will make your Androids and your iPhones crash. Allahu Akbar. It consists of 2 million working parts. It can detect between 25 different color images, and it could differentiate between 500 shades of gray. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Who's the creator now? Who's the maker now? Who's the shaper now? Allah is the maker. Allah is the shaper. Allah is the creator. Then you go a step further. You look at the heart that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you. It beats 72 times a minute, 100,000 times a day, 3,600,000 times a year. Allahu Akbar. It pumps 2,000 gallons of blood through 60,000 miles of blood vessels a day. Who is the one who makes this heartbeat without a battery pack, without any supply of power? Allahu Akbar. And according to researchers, they say, so powerful is his heart that he could pull a truck for 20 miles. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Who's the creator now? Who's the maker now? Who's the shaper now? Allah is the creator. Allah is the maker. Allah is the shaper. Then you go a step further. Then you realize that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you a brain. So powerful is his brain. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. According to researchers, they say that it has 60, 70,000 miles of blood vessels in the brain. Allahu Akbar, could you imagine 70,000 miles of blood vessels in your brain? Allahu Akbar, who is the one who created that brain that could store thousands and thousands of gigabytes of terabytes of memory? Allahu Akbar, Allah is the one who gave you that brain. So powerful is this brain that according to researchers, they say they're so powerful they could light a bulb up. Who's the creator now? Who's the maker now? Who's the shaper now? Allah is the creator. Allah is the maker. Allah is the shaper. Then why is it Thomas Edison is praised? Benjamin Franklin is praised. Kim Kardashian and Nicki Minaj is praised. Stormzy and Floyd Mayweather are praised. Allahu Akbar. But why is it that we're not praising Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that very man that praised Allah Azza wa Jalla from the day he was born till the day he passed away? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. People go around and they start boasting. They think they're bad. They have some new designer wear, or they have the latest phone or the latest watch, and all of a sudden the guy's got pride. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Realize this, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that regarding this angel Jibreel, he has 600 wings. So powerful is this angel. They took a city so close to the lowest heaven, and then so close that according to narration, it says that the angels heard the dogs barking, the chickens croaking. They overturned the city and he slammed it back onto the earth. Who is the one who created this angel? Allah is the one. When you realize this, you will realize you are nothing. Then you go a step further. The angels who are carrying Allah's throne, the distance between the earlobe and the neck is 70,000 years. 70,000 years. 70,000 years. When you realize this, you will realize you are nothing. You will realize that your pride will go out of the window. Allahu Akbar. This is the Almighty Allah, the King of all kings, the Master of the Day of Judgment, the one, the only Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Mighty. Why? He is the owner. He is the Lord of majesty and bounty. He is the gatherer. He is the rich. He is the enricher. He is the powerful one. He is the one who guides. He is the light. He is the righteous. This is Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Mighty. Allahu Akbar. You realize that man commits sin by night and day. Night and day, we were nothing and Allah the Almighty guided us. We were hungry, Allah Azza wa Jalla fed us. We were unclothed and Allah the Almighty clothed us, then you realize that we commit sin by night and day. Allahu Akbar. Allah could have made it that we could have been those people who were from the previous nation disgraced. Why? Because every time that they committed a sin, the next morning they used to wake up, the sin used to be written on their door, and every single person used to recognize that this person committed this sin. We are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We were honored by the King of all Kings. The Lord the Almighty will conceal our sins, and He who makes tawbah, Allah the Almighty will forgive their sin. He will forgive their sin. Forgive their sin. Allahu Akbar. If you committed sin, then number the froth on the ocean. You return to Allah. You ask Allah for forgiveness. Allah will forgive your sin. If you committed sin, then reach the peaks of some mountains. You return to Allah. You ask Allah for forgiveness. Allah will forgive your sins. Why? Because it's the sunnah of Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty. Those who sin and those who return to Allah with sincere repentance and with remorse, Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive their sin. He will forgive their sin. He will forgive their sin. This is the King of all Kings, the Master of the Day of Judgment, the one, the only, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty. And this is why I conclude by saying that why is it that storms Skepta, Justin Bieber, Kim Kardashian, Nicki Minaj, they are praised? Isn't Allah Azza wa Jalla enough for you? Isn't Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam enough for you? Isn't Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali enough for you? Isn't Khalid bin Walid, Salahuddin, Nuruddin enough for you? My brothers, you never know when your end is near. Every single person is guilty in this day and age that they do not praise the King of the world, Master of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty, the way He should be praised. How are we going to praise Allah? The ultimate way is that you stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty 5 times a day. Bowing, standing, praising Allah, because above in the center of the world is the Kaaba. Above the Kaaba, 500 years is the first heaven. In the first heaven, there is a house, and in the house, there's angels that are praising Allah. There are angels who are doing tawaf around the house. Some are in ruku, some are in sujood, some are in qiyam, and they'll remain like that right till the day of judgment. My brothers, you just never know. Today, you are healthy. Tomorrow, you could be bedridden. Why? Because there was a person, wallahi, his wife used to say that, guide him. Tell me about religion that I could explain to him and make him a better husband. He lives a life of sin. He lives a life of disobedience. And all of a sudden, weeks passed, months passed, even years passed. I used to warn him. Change. You never know when your end is near. Imagine Allah Azza wa Jalla, He takes your eyes away from you. He takes your ability away from you. He says, one day I'll change. Then after 4 years of me contacting him, speaking to him, I said to him, do you know what? This is my final visit. You want to believe? Then believe. You don't want to believe? Then don't believe. And I walked out. But before I walked out, and I said that, wallahi, you have no excuses now. A warner has come, and Allah sent me to tell you to change. 4 years have passed. I go, could you just imagine from this day on, you lose your sight and you become bedridden. Few weeks later, I get a call from his family. They go that he has a problem. You need to come down. I went to the hospital. There he was, weighing 5 stones with a brain hemorrhage, paralyzed head to toe, and the only thing he could move is his eyes. And I said to him, do you remember every single meeting we had? I used to remind you of this, that could you imagine that Allah Azza wa Jalla takes your abilities away from you? Tears flow from his eyes, but he cannot speak and he cannot move. Right till this present day, 2.5 years have passed and he's in the hospital in the same state. We pray to Allah that Allah the Almighty cures him. But this could happen to any one of us. Today, we are fit to work, to walk, and to talk. We could praise Allah. But could you just imagine you wake up the next morning? You feel a bit ill. You go to the doctors. Doctors refer you to the hospital, and all of a sudden the hospital says that you've got cancer and you've only got 1 month to live. I swear by Allah, there are people out there who just wish they had your lifestyle, that they could walk, they could speak, they could worship Allah, and some living in the poor countries, what runs through their mind is, if only we had a life like yours. Before Allah Azza wa Jalla takes every single thing away from you, return to the King of the world, Master of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty. I begun by praising Allah, I end by saying, justice will not be done by praising Allah by people like us. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.